Corey, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Craig Nicol. He's the CEO of Graphene Manufacturing Group. And Craig, it's good to have you back again. How are you?
I'm well, thanks. Good to be back here again. Thanks, Steve.
Yeah, some exciting news out from the company. We'll get to that in just a second, but maybe just remind everyone a little bit about Graphene Manufacturing Group.
Yeah, so Graphene Manufacturing Group is a six-year-old Australian public company. We're listed on the Toronto Stock Exchange of Ventures and also in Germany and OTC Pink Sheets. So we actually make graphene from natural gas. We invented that ourselves, but then we go and put that into products and we sell those products. And we have an energy savings coating system. And also we have this Graphene Aluminium-Ion Battery, which we've just updated news on this week. So I'd love to talk more about that.
Yeah, let's talk about that, because last time you had one of these updates was about a year ago. It was June 22nd, 2021, so over a year ago, and you put out new numbers significantly better. So just give me some thoughts on the new numbers and how good they are.
Yeah, so we put out a numbers on the performance data for a graphene aluminium ion battery, which we own. Now we license the tech off University of Queensland. So this is our globally exclusive tech, as well as our graphene that we produce. So we're now sitting at, it basically double the energy density we said we could do last year. Now it's over 300 watt hours per kilogram. And no doubt your listeners and viewers would know that, you know, that lithium ion batteries really only sit at around 200 or so watt hours per kilogram, or maybe a bit more. So we're now exceeding, the energy density of lithium ion batteries, which is really something special. But what's amazing is, we're also sitting at 30% faster charging. So that means we're sitting at 100 times faster charging than lithium ion batteries now, which is really quite astounding. So it's a hybrid supercapacitor with no lithium or copper or cobalt, just graphene and aluminium, really something special.
And maybe you can sort of talk about that just a little bit more, because the one thing people are always looking for is how you get the battery performance to increase while not having to increase the things that are inside of it. And that's what it seems like you're able to do here, which is a pretty big step forward.
Yeah, so that's all down to the graphene and how we make the graphene. Tested graphenes from around the world and different types, and generally everyone else makes graphene from graphite. And what we've seen is our graphene is substantially better. The way we make it and how we make it for our battery, many times better. So that's the first thing. That's actually, in the end, often the biggest contributor to energy density is how many aluminium, we use the aluminium atom instead of the lithium atom, which is obviously a lot more stable and lower cost to find and get. And that stores, our carbon stores the aluminium atom. And the more aluminium ions or atoms you can store in the cathode, the higher energy density you have. So that's what we're able to do. And that's effectively how we're able to double our energy density over the last year, is that we've found ways of storing it better in the same graphene, which is really something special and, you know, clearly world leading. But in a lot of ways also, we've gone and solved a lot of the issues that typically have with when you get a new technology out of a laboratory. And so we've gone to solve about 10 different issues as well. And so we really feel like we've broken the sciences back here. And now we're really looking forward of how to get the final engineering into the product and start to potentially look at some kind of final investment decision for a automated factory for our battery.
And what's the timeline around that? When do you hope to make those kind of decisions? Because obviously those are pretty significant decisions.
Yeah, and you know, we're really keen to start with looking at coin cells. They've absolutely a unique battery, thousands of cycles and really fast charging. Lithium battery really is the only one that's on the market right now, single use. So we'd look to try to progress that into these little button batteries into some type of final investment decision in 2023, and look to get into production if everything goes well, obviously with a number of things to get there in 2024. So you know, really in the next 2 years, we hope to be able to be in millions of batteries production per annum of button cells or coin cells, they're called.
Yeah.
But then after that, we'd look to get into these types of batteries, which are types of pouch cells. And that's the type of battery which is mass scale, can be used in grid and vehicles and phones and laptops. And that's the battery that we have lots of really big, some of the biggest companies in the world under NDA talking to us about how to use. And that's transformative in terms of many industries. But that first coin cell project will show the world that GMG can make its own graphene, make batteries, and basically start producing them and selling them. And then people can take us a whole lot more seriously around our pouch cell technology, which is obviously a much bigger step and a much bigger project. So, and that'll be, we think, probably a couple of years later.
All right, we'll leave it there. It sounds like it's a good roadmap that we'll be following as well. Craig, thanks so much. Great to catch up with you. Appreciate it.
Thanks a lot, Steve.
All right, there's Craig Nicol, the CEO of Graphene Manufacturing Group.